And here we are at this charming two-bedroom, one-bath bungalow in Galveston. It's close to the beach and in the middle of town. As you come up the front steps, there's a great little front porch here with a porch swing. It has the original windows. Scanning around, that's going to be the high school football field right over there. And then you've got tennis courts over there. And right around the corner is the public pool, which has a splash pad and all that, which is kind of fun. The original front door. Entering, come into the living room. And it's fun. It's nicely done with whimsy. There's shears over almost all the windows with 2-inch mini blinds under our blinds underneath. There is a Pac-Man machine, Miss Pac-Man. So if you know anyone likes playing Miss Pac-Man, there's a place for you. Got leather furniture throughout here. Original floors, baseboards, big TV, beautiful ceiling fans. There's two of them in the living room. Walking along. Great light from all the windows. Over here, there's a secretary with, you get your sign in and your things to do here in Galveston. And then there's a little vignette here with these two chairs and a picture. And we're gonna keep going through. And ahead, there's the original phone nook. The only area of the house that is not the original wood floors is the kitchen and dining area, which has slate in a herringbone pattern. So you've got a full-sized dining table here with a great window with light, an enormous refrigerator, a bar area with stools, leads into the kitchen, where it has a gas range, oven, utensils, of course, overhead vent, your toaster, microwave, all your coffee and creamer and those things. We've got lots of cabinet space down below, and these are granite countertops throughout, all over there and here. And then your glassware, dishes, adult beverageware. It does have a full-size dishwasher, more cabinets, lots of drawers, a coffee maker, great plates for entertaining. Just pan back around. We're going to go to the largest of the two bedrooms. This was once used as the primary bedroom, but since it's a vacation rental, they use it as the kids' room, basically. So it's got two queen-size beds and lots of space. There's a large closet here, and it has the original over closet storage bins for seasonal stuff. That's looking out in the backyard. We'll be there in a minute. There are four windows and two ceiling fans with light kits. It does have central air, as well as, if you've heard that music in the background, there is piped in music throughout the house. It's all off of one Yamaha receiver that's in the living room. So that's pretty cool too. You can kind of jam in here. The bathroom has great tile, pull around, shower curtain, chair, toilet, vanity, mirror, overhead lighting. It also has a curling iron and a hair dryer. Standard things to happen in your vacation rental. And then on this back wall, ta-da, a full-size washer and dryer with overhead storage. And there's your speaker in the bathroom, so you're not gonna go without music in here too. There's a nice niche in the shower as well for your soaps and shampoo and things. And then this is the front bedroom, which is a rust color and palm. It's very, very soothing and relaxing feeling. It's like homey and it's just great. It's got a TV. All the bedrooms have TVs. Let's look at that. And right there is the front porch and the porch swing that I showed you earlier. And come back around this way. We're back to the living room. And this one, of course, has a huge TV. So, let's keep going. Let's go a little further. What do you think is behind this door? Well, it's the courtyard. But it's been decked out. It's got a great grill right here and a fire pit, chairs, and a tiki bar. Get your R's in here. Late nights playing cards or dominoes or darts. It doesn't keep score, but it's still fun to play. Funky, very Galveston, little chandeliers out here. It's a neat little space. Hello. Ooh, hello. There is a green space between this main bungalow and the garage in the back. I'm going to show you this up here. There's a storage room here for like the lawn equipment or anything that you might need to store. And up these stairs is a sun deck. So you can come up here, the guests can come up here anytime and just catch a few rays and relax and be kind of up above it all. Looking down, there's the green area, there's the fire pit, barbecue, there's the roof on the house in case you're interested. And coming back around this way into the garage / man cave / mother-in-law suite / flex space. Before we get there, this one in there, there is an outdoor shower here. And it's low maintenance everywhere. So we got the zero maintenance crushed marble, and there's a gate to the alley. Coming into the garage, you do have a full bay for a car or a truck that has a garage door opener. The other side also has a garage door opener, so you can open this whole space up. And this is your kitchenette with all the basic necessities except for a hot plate. This whole structure in here is built so that it is not permanent. It can be taken out if you want just a two-car garage. This will come right out. It's not permanently affixed to the building, like in the concrete or anything. You do have washer and dryer connections here. You've got a bathroom. So when you're working on the car, you've got a place to wash your hands, which is always great. And it gets even better. You've got a place to take a shower in case you get really messy. And a toilet right here. That opens up into a queen size bedroom. You got a dresser, lamp, and then you got a mini split air conditioner in here. Queen size bed, it's brand new. Some baker's shelves with towels and sundries on them, as well as a TV. Can't go anywhere without a TV. And it does have this neat ceiling fan light that I'm not even sure exactly how it works, but it's neat. And back out this way, ta-da, you're back in the garage. And I think I forgot to mention the garage, just in case your car gets bored, has a ginormous big screen TV. So, gonna take us outside and we'll be ending up the tour there. The garage door here, it's not quite a seaside place in Paris or anything, but it's pretty cool. So we got clear access to the alley going both directions. So that's going to conclude our tour of this beautiful 2-1 bungalow with bonus garage, flex space, whatever you want to call it, however you want to use it. The options are endless and up to you. So if you're interested, give me a call, William Jenkins, 409-526-9439. And we'll see you in a bungalow soon.